Okay, in this video I want to talk about completing the square, and I'm going to complete the square and solve a quadratic equation. And this will be the first of two examples. This one will be a little easier. So here we're going to solve the quadratic equation x squared minus 6x plus 8. And you could definitely factor this one without too much trouble, but you know, I want to talk about understanding the procedure here. So let's do it kind of the longer way. The first thing you want to do is you look at the x terms basically that are in there, and you want the coefficient of the x squared term to equal 1, which it does in this case. If not, you have to factor it out, and I'll do something like that in a separate example. So we have this condition. So what we then do is we just kind of stick that in a set of parentheses, the first two, give yourself a little space, and then I'm going to write my plus 8, give myself a little space, equals 0. So the whole point, the way you complete the square is you look at whatever number is in front of the x term. So in this case, the number in front of the x, the coefficient on the x term, is 1/2. We then take 1/2 of that number, so you always take 1/2 of it. So 1/2 of negative 6 will be negative 3. And then what you do is you square it. And then you put that number back inside of there. So if we square it, we'll get positive 9. Okay, so we've actually just thrown in a brand new number that wasn't there before. We put in this positive 9 that wasn't there. Well, the way that we can get rid of it in this case is, I mean, basically imagine just getting rid of the parentheses. We would get back the original thing, except our plus 9 would be there. Well, to cancel it out, we're going to subtract 9. Okay. Notice this is all happening on the left side of the equal sign. Okay, so now we just simplify down a little bit more. And the point is, you can write this stuff in parentheses as a perfect square. This actually factors now as x minus 3 times x minus 3. Okay, and again, if you take whatever 1/2 of the coefficient on the x term was, it was a negative 3, that's what will go inside the parentheses. Positive 8 minus 9 is negative 1, equals 0. So now we write the first part as x minus 3 squared minus 1 equals 0. Okay, so again, we're trying to solve a quadratic equation here. What we do at this point is you now simply add the 1 to both sides. So x minus 3 squared equals positive 1. And the whole point of solving a quadratic equation by completing the square is getting to the step that we're at right now. Because what we're going to do is we're going to take the square root of both sides. So if we take the square root of both sides, x minus 3 squared equals the square root of the right side. Okay, so once we take square roots, we should put a positive or negative on one side. On the left, if you take the square root of a quantity squared, we'll just get the x minus 3. And this will equal either positive or negative 1. So now we get our two separate equations that we have to solve. One of the equations that we'll have to solve will be x minus 3 equals positive 1. And then the other equation we'll have to solve will be x minus 3 equals negative 1. Okay, so we'll simply add 3 in both cases, and we'll get x equals positive 4 as one of our solutions. If you add positive 3 to the other side, we'll get x equals positive 2 as our other solution. And you can check that if you do plug 2 and 4 back into the original equation, you will get 0 out. So, all right, so this will be example 1. In my extra example, I'm going to change the coefficient on the x squared just to make it a little more tedious. So stick around if you need to see that example. It should be close by.